Blackstone Publishing presents The Deer Stalker by Zane Gray. This book is read by Russell Bentley.
Chapter 1. Thad Eburne rode slowly down a trail through the forest of Buckskin Mountain. It led from his lonely cabin to one of the ranger stations called VT Park. He had blazed and trodden it himself, a winding trail, made to dodge the automobile roads that during recent years had extended too far, he thought, into the wilderness of his beloved deer sanctuary. He loved the great herd of deer on Buckskin, and though he did not hate civilization, he feared its encroachment into what should always have been kept virgin forest. Afternoon was far advanced, and the warmth of the early summer day was fading. Shafts of golden sunlight slanted down through the giant pines and spruces of the open forest. Big blue grouse flew up from the thickets along the trail and sped away in noisy flight. And every open glade showed at least one of the squirrels peculiar to that forest plateau. They were black as coal, had tufted ears and huge, furry white tails. Eburne paid more attention to these than to the deer that he encountered everywhere along the trail. It hurt him to look at them because of late he was always taking stock of their leanness or counting their rips, for the deer of Buckskin Forest were starving, and that was the deer stalker's great concern. In a way, Thad Eburne had sacrificed himself to the cause of forest conservation. True, he had first sought the ranger life to regain rugged health, but having achieved it years ago, he had not returned to the home and advantages he had left back in New England. A life in the open had always been his dream, and the West had claimed him. He was past 30 now. His ambition had been to work himself up in the service, to the point where he could travel from one national forest preserve to another, fostering his ideals of conservation. But that long since had become only a dream. His very love of the wild animals, his antagonism to the killing of even wolves and wildcats, and especially cougars, had incurred the enmity of men above him in the service. Besides that, he had fought the building of roads and the overtures of lumbering and mining men who would have exploited the beautiful preserve for their greedy ends. There were cattlemen, too, who hated Eburne for sternly holding them to their prescribed grazing permits. Graft had not worked with this ranger, and men of little brief authority found him a hard nut to crack. Wherefore, he had remained merely a ranger, and had been advised that even his present situation was none too secure. Thad had not worried himself by dwelling upon this implied threat. Still, as he rode down the trail, on his return to VT Park, where he knew he must encounter one or more of his enemies and deliver reports that he knew would be disliked, his thoughts were far from pleasant. Next to the great herd of deer, he loved this vast plateau, upon the level summit of which Buckskin Forest stretched its dark growth of virgin conifers. He felt that probably no living man, certainly none in the service, knew this vast, silent place so well as he. For 8 years he had ranged it, sometimes alone for months, exploring, mapping, studying the deer, the snow, the water, the timber, the grass. The wonder of that plateau country never lost its enchantment for the deer stalker. It was Grand Canyon country. Buckskin Forest occupied the highest eminence for many miles around. To the north, the dim round dome of Navajo Mountain peeped above the red ramparts across the interventing desert. To the south, equally distant, the sharp San Francisco peaks notched the azure sky. The plateau itself was geologically a fault, an abrupt crack and upthrust of the crust of the earth, 100 miles and more of its southern...
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.